provide emergency shelter for women and children who are fleeing domestic violence or who are homeless due to other crisis situations.
We're not just a shelter, we're also an outreach, helping the moms and the kids get the supports that they may not be able to or didn't know they could access through the school systems or through community clubs and stuff.
And we're here for to listen and whatever we can do to help these ladies who have gone through a lot of trauma.
I'd say we work with probably about 75% First Nations. So the work that we do needs to reflect the clients that come to see our shelter.
We have a lovely elder, Lillian, that comes in once a month. We have a room downstairs called Serenity Room. Any of our Indigenous ladies who are used to smudging can go down at any time and smudge. We try to be culturally sensitive at all times. When our moms arrive here, they've usually arrived from a pretty compact family system. So there's been a gookum or an auntie or somebody help. Then they come here and they've got nobody. Nobody, they don't know anybody. And I think that's really tough. Finances, of course, are huge. Housing is, especially for our moms who come in with more than one or two children, is brutal. Brutal. And then finding them all the, you know, all the things that we take for granted. Couches and tables and chairs and clothing and healthcare and transportation, and it's quite overwhelming at times.
There's more than just the educational factor to it. I'm able to help them build their confidence, build their trust again, and work with each other and just feel safe. And then once that is established, then the learning can come. Any kid transferring is like so difficult, right? It's stressful and you feel alone. Here, they're not alone. They're with me. There's other kids, you know, and it's easier. That's one thing that they just can not worry about. They just come downstairs. Sometimes when they come in, like they're just very lost, right? So then what we can start with is just the basics, like, hey, do you know how to add? And they're like, yeah. And I'm like, right on, let's do a math sheet and we'll add. And then the next day will be like each day increases, building up their confidence. It's very important to be upbeat and happy and we're going to do all these fun things and yeah. And then there's moments where sometimes we have to sit in a sharing circle and just, if emotions come, right? And it's just being open and flexible and really assessing my kids all the time, like where they're at, how they're doing, you know, and make those adjustments. Lots of times kids will, when I come in at 8:30, we don't start school until 10 to 9, and they'll pace, and they'll be like waiting for me if I'm in like the CIW office or whatever, and they'll be like, is it school yet? Is it school? Like, so it's wonderful that they get excited to go to school and that they're excited to be in the classroom.
Domestic violence is really prevalent in Alberta, as well as across the country, and it takes a very strong woman to leave an abusive situation.
I'm kind of amazed at is the resiliency within our families. You know, when you hear their stories and I think, I don't know if I could have made it this far. I really don't know if I could have reached out and asked for help.
I really think that there's change coming. There's change happening now, but I really see it moving in a really positive direction, and all of us working together, you know, to just end domestic violence.